My goal 45.
Cheering a shimmer.
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
So this lunch band was
death rash. A prisoner.
And then we had thoughts.
Sleeper dislodged.
Inconsiderate
strain. Like, you know, members, areas.
I think you tell them this last time.
Was on
the real
level. Absolutely.
You did not really
have a lot of control or so many of
the instruments. Is that what
they mean? We just finished
working this
year. S4. PCC, NHS, as an entourage.
So that most of my life,
Alligator and Chamon, and
a relationship with others. I pushed around in
Japan and I promised they should pass the guitar. Bars everywhere. Last time you missed it.
There's also a bittersweet
time.
provide you to draw.
Because these days,
I
just
got huge chicken.
Yeah,
dairy.
And you saw
like the wax cap.
Business.
We're going to
have to
Salmon, take one that down like
that.
Jeffrey Morgan, Mark Tantris, solo piano improvisation by the
end.
Jeffrey Morgan,
two days ago.
Ninja Leaders.
And notes.
Richard Kodecki. Invisible Image.
Whatever that may
be. The Lord Mark Willis Prescott.
This was a meeting I needed.
Stefano Barban. Buddy Alphany.
And as I mentioned before, I'm going to
be
1964 to 1970. Keep up.
It was something.
1975 to 1991. Then came Montgomery, the first post-mission study, 1980 and 1989. The teaching of numbers, really.
She had a training.
That was the CA, which was your investment. At the Willow Corner,
he's
going to pass down by Willow Corner to the right of the Bell School.
Some of the materials,
falling out of iron, just a little bit longer, no framework.
In some ways, you can almost consider this
your work at the vanguard. Your favorite, 1928, 1979.
Again, they'll
have a seminarily same.
Then have prepared it for what lies
ahead. For me, it's been yes. Besides, it will change their home. Jerry Hunt,
the exact
one to claim.
Both his and my mind.
And Brian Chase.
That's why I'm here. This series of tapes, then two, Green 3, C60. Number 4, also maker. Charlotte, Mr. Media, is the CD with the quote unquote CD business, basically the toilet. Realize that the words of the might not be coming out from price of time, or if ever. If I waited for a CD or LP
witness.
So these cassettes can be considered official, or demos, or just tapes for sales and gigs. I'm not even sure. They'll likely be limited editions. The music on all of them are finished works that can be considered rough mixes. They have not been mixed and mastered professionally. That eventually did happen down the line, and they did CDR and also did a CD. This was released on In Your Disco, the Indian label, and I was very pleased by their interest in releasing these works. As I continue to work away with these pieces, it would be nice to have gotten much of this material out of the world that I wrote to the war. It does feel strange going back to a bit more of a DIY, do it yourself situation, my own work releases. The past year also saw a 3-cassette set and a live tape from a 2013 European tour. I have to admit it's a bit hard facing the fact that I'm going to see the future, or I'm not releasing any of my own work myself. Maybe that's a good thing? Too expensive in reality. And so it feels strange not to have something easily on hand to give away. I've gotten used to being able to just hand a CD to someone.
Kann abhängig dann natürlich die italienische Methode, das kann ab, auf Musik übertragen. und dann Geräusche und Text miteinander verbunden. So.
Ja.
So cut up. The kind of cut up.
About the music?
Yes.
And maybe
collage.
Suppose that, so the story of the music is that I was doing a performance with Dan Warburton in Ghent, and he, as part of the backing team, he took all the music he had for me, because he's a reviewer, and he squished it, stretched it. He even forgot what he did, so he kind of combined it into a 45-minute piece that he sent to me before we played.
Okay.
And what happened when we were going to perform over that, when I got to Belgium, my computer broke. And so, while I was trying to figure out how to get my computer fixed or whatever, I was sitting there trying to figure out if this has not worked, what do I do? And so that I was literally sitting in Phil Leblanc, the composer's kitchen in Ghent, and just played Dan's recording of all my stuff back into the room while I just sat there with a recorder. And then actually when we played it live, we did I did get a computer back. It wasn't mine, but I was working with a computer, and I played both versions together, his and mine, recorded, not quite synced up, and then we played over that. And then when I got back home to New York, I took those two pieces and then kind of put them together. And Dan is also a composer and had a one-minute piano piece on like a Virgo CD, and I just stretched that to 45 minutes.
So
there's a low tone. Hear them at all, a 45-minute stretch, and then it's all combined together, and it's a recycling. Yeah, recycling.
Also, um das für mich zusammenzufassen, also beruht vor allen Dingen auf der Kooperation mit einem belgischen Künstler, Komponisten.
Ja, das Stück Musik, was wir gehört haben.
Ja. Und das ist eben von einer Minute, muss ich mal wieder dort drücken, von einer Minute von dem Komponisten auf 45 Minuten gedehnt.
Ja, es sind verschiedene Teile. Der Belgier hatte wiederum Sachen von L gemixt und L hat ein Stück von dem Dan Warburton von einer Minute auf 45 Minuten.
Spannend, finde ich spannend. Oder? Also irgendwie,
das war dann sozusagen so der Background-Sound.
Okay, ja.
Ja, und das hat er eben zusammengesetzt zu diesem neuen Stück, was wir eben
So, und morgen Abend ist El ja auch wieder da, mit anderen Musikern, mit dir auch. Da kommt noch ein Gitarrist und so. Und,
genau.
Ja, okay.
Robert auch schon hier.
Ah, okay.
Sind dann
auch Tim's going to play also.
Okay.
Und das wird dann aber ein bisschen was anderes natürlich sein. Dieses hier war ein vorgeplantes Stück.
Ah, da wird improvisiert morgen Abend auch, dass ihr...
Morgen wird es dann eher, wir werden sehen, in Progression.
Spannend, also klasse. Also.
Das ist also noch nichts.
Also ich habe ja eben schon überlegt beim Filmen, wie ich das in Bilder übersetzen kann. Ja. Ich habe auch schon ein paar Ideen. Da werde ich mich dran machen auch, und das ist natürlich für mich eine spannende Herausforderung auch. Ne? Klasse, irgendwie, Ende offen. Felix, was hast du? Felix?
Also, all the tracks together, it sounded quite well, but I would have preferred to have lessened the track for better understanding, because sometimes I really would have liked to understand. I only understood some German words, some English words, and I think a little bit the way it was too much on the pure sound, on a little bit too... Little bit to little, on the weight of the words.
Yeah.
And my interest is also being focused on words. Huh?
When you are working with words.
Yeah.
So we can give the translation.
you should do for reading.
Or maybe the original text.
That was probably a different purpose. They wanted just to give everybody the chance to test his own capacity to cope with the material and how to process it in his mind. So maybe what Felix said, it was hard to
To follow.
Yeah. And but we wanted to last 45 minutes, and so this is maybe something you have to go back through your mind and see. I think it's like a sea with waves and different sounds. And I also have imaginations, like pictures. When you say it's a Belgian composer, it reminds me of Belgian landscapes. So can you say anything about the intent you have to make such a piece? Intention?
I don't like this. The other thing, I do not like to stand up there for 45 minutes and deliver a text. So part of it was, how do I make it interesting to, you know, for myself and the audience that, and again, not necessarily, you know, not knowing everybody's, you know, I mean, everyone probably speaks much better English than, I mean, I don't speak any German, so you guys are way ahead of me. So as we thought about it, it was kind of like maybe a bit of uninteresting just as a performance as much as a lecture. And so, you know, there is the level of, you know, possible unintelligibility, and, you know, can you fight your way through it a little bit? So, and again, there is, I can send anyone who wants the English text, and you actually have the German text, so if you actually want to read...
What's the translation?
Yeah, so you can post the German translation of the text through Google, which has a little extra...
So that makes it, so that destroyed also the content a little bit, but I tried by reading to get the content again into the text. The text is about me. Yeah, that's about me. Yeah, also the text is über L, also über seine Art zu komponieren, über die Art, wie Platten produziert, also CDs, Kassetten und so weiter. Und vielleicht ist das Stück auch so eine Art Illustration, weil wir hatten das eben, Raimund hat ja gefragt, wie das Stück entstanden ist. Und vielleicht ist das dann auch die Antwort gewesen, im Grunde, dass das Stück war so eine Art Präsentation, wie dann ein Stück entsteht, letztlich bei L.
I understood what you explained before. I thought there was actually something in the back there that you had in the back of your mind, like the appearance of the whole performance. Also on a meditative kind of thing, you can get deeper and deeper into the sound, like a vortex in a way.
I like the many layers of gears. A lot of my work is very layered, so having that element that you like, the use of text, and, you know, this sort of even the, you hearing it but not hearing it, and kind of grabbing it, but I tend to not be quite that philosophical. I like the rec things.
But they are also kind of long pieces.
Yeah.
So that is aspect of this.
What comes to your mind and even yourself is the Man of History by the Van Renneberg. It's probably one of the first pieces that comes together in different voices and sound. Is that an influence for you? How did Van Renneberg, like the Man of History, so a 50-minute piece of Van, remember that probably? It's not really something you have in the back.
No, not specifically. It was just, how do I make this work? And, you know, and again, you know, it started as the lecture, and as I went through it, like just lecturing or speaking is less interesting to me than maybe making a performance of it. So.
Yeah, when you're one note for the layering, you are layering the language.